Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about what our Holy Father said in Fratelli Tutti. Fratelli Tutti is humanism in its core. Yes friends, Fratelli Tutti is humanism in its core. Central to the humanism is the worth and dignity of the human being. Basic to this deep humanism is equality and fraternity. In this encyclical, Pope Francis gives a universal call to respect, accept, and love all others as brothers and sisters by recognizing them equal in dignity, rights, duties, and loving every person with a love without borders. To achieve social friendship and universal fraternity, it is necessary to call for an acknowledgement of the worth of every person. Unless this fundamental right to live with dignity is upheld, there will be no future either for fraternity or for the survival of humanity. Human person is precious and sacred. Human beings are not things or objects to be used, abused, and later discarded. Things are for use. Persons are not for use. For things, usefulness is the cheap title for value. But persons are of immense worth and dignity simply because they are human beings. Their worth does not consist in what they have, or what they do, or what they appear to others, or what others think of them, but they are human beings. They have intrinsic and inherent dignity, irrespective of religion, nationality, gender, language, color, ideology, or ethnicity. Persons are not means, or simply functions to carry out what one wants. Human dignity is the bedrock of all human and moral values. At the heart of Fratelli Tutti is concern for human dignity. It is a foundation of equality, fraternity, justice, and peace. It is the basis for human rights and duties. Every human is precious and sacred, and hence treated with utmost respect, reverence, dignity, awe, and admiration. The encyclical is a call to recognize and affirm the dignity of every human being without borders. The Pope very clearly writes, "Not even a murderer loses his personal dignity. Likewise, a leper. Every human being is considered to be of immense value, worthy, pleasing, beautiful, and spiritual beyond the physical and moral appearance. No flower is ever ugly. Each person is beautiful and good, carefully grafted, uniquely endowed by the great artist. Human beings matter, and matter all the time. They matter more than ideas or things. Persons cannot be subordinated to things, machines, or systems, because all exists for persons and their common good. The most important reality in life is not our relation to things or principles, but our relationship to persons. Our relationship to person depends upon our perception, the way we look at human beings. Often we perceive human beings through the glasses of caste, creed, gender, language, and ethnicity, etc. We need to look at human beings as Jesus looked at them, as a precious children of God. Experience everyone as sisters and brothers. We often address others as brothers and sisters, or write as brothers and sisters. But the real question is, do we feel or experience others as my brothers and sisters? Only when we experience others as my brothers and sisters, then we will have compassion. Compassion connects us to one another. The Pope rightly points out that globalization makes us the neighbors and not brothers and sisters. Globalization focuses on markets and profits, not on shared humanity or common humanity. All belong to one God, Father of all, and we are all God's precious children, and among ourselves, truly as sisters and brothers. One human family, one flesh indeed. In the novel Les Miserables, written by Victor Hugo, the escaped convict Jean-Val Jean introduced him as a burglar, escaped prisoner, and dangerous man to a bishop. To which bishop answers, "I know you. Your name is brother," or Leo Tolstoy. Once, when he found no money on him to give as alms, he spontaneously reached out with his arms and embraced the beggar, kissed him on the cheek and said, "Don't be angry with me, my brother. I have nothing to give you." The beggar, deeply touched, and responded, "But you called me brother. That is a great, great, great gift that you have given to me." When we don't experience the others as my brothers and sisters, I will have no compassion. Here, I will not be affected by their sufferings. I'll become indifferent, apathetic, look the other way, passing by. What is more, caught up as we are with our own comforts, other becomes a disturbance, a nuisance. Often, the other is eclipsed, excluded, displaced, reduced to a word, to a number, to a thing, sometimes even an enemy. It is exactly what Cain says, "Am I my brother's keeper?" Only fraternal love and compassionate creates a universal family. In the name of God, the Pope makes humble appeal to us to adopt a culture of universal fraternity, culture of encounter and listening and social bonding, always begging from the least of our brothers and sisters, like those excluded, exploited, ignored, forgotten, not yet useful like the unborn, or no longer needed like the elderly. No one is useless and expendable. All are human beings. All are precious children of God. All are my brothers and sisters. Christian faith gives us added motivation and inspiration. We are called to recognize suffering Christ in the poor and the excluded, homeless, migrants, refugees, indigenous, elderly victims of human beings, trafficking, vulnerable women, and unborn children. God's word teaches that our brothers and sisters in pain and suffering are the prolongation of the incarnation and crucifixion for each of us. Matthew 25 and 40. They are the suffering flesh of Christ, as Pope Francis puts it. may we recognize Christ in the excluded and discarded and be close to them. They are human beings, precious children of God, our brothers and sisters, and thus built a world of human fraternity. Yes, dear friends, let us consider everyone in the world as our brothers and sisters.